Hello, welcome to Spine Educational Channel. In this video, we will cover everything about IK constraints that will help you to construct more flexible rigs in spine. For the detailed idea, I want to thank Castiel for suggesting it in the comments. Guys, I read every comment on this channel, so if you have any suggestion, write it under any of our videos. That will be very helpful for our channel to grow it in the right direction. Okay, back to the idea. Now I will explain you what are the IK constraints, how to build them, how to use them, and at the end I will show you some examples of my previous rigs where I use IK constraints from simple to complex. Let's start. What means IK? When we first construct bones in spine, parent and child relations are being calculated as forward kinematics, shortly FK. That means that the child will follow its parent bone. This can work in most of the cases, but sometimes we need some external force to affect our skeleton, such as ground or maybe a weapon. In those cases, we need to use inverse kinematics, shortly IK. IK works the opposite way, meaning that the parent bone will be affected by the child bone. For instance, if we set up a leg IK constraint, the foot will not be moved if we move its parent bone. Instead, the foot bone can affect the parent bone. So we will have a mix of FK and IK, where one force comes from the hip bone as FK and the other force comes from the foot as IK. That will give us a functional leg. In spine, you can create IK constraints for one or two bones. Unfortunately, there is no way to create IK constraints for more than two bones. A common mistake is to create an IK forearm just to control it using one bone. Doing that, you will lose the freedom of using lower arm for follow-through motions. Instead, create an IK constraint only when you see an external force affecting one of the bones. It can be environment interaction, such as ground, table, wall, or it can be the skeleton itself. Maybe character places his arm on his waist. Or holding two-handed sword. In those cases, yes, it is the best to add an arm IK. But remember, when you add an IK, it doesn't mean you have to use it in all animations. You can always turn the IK off in animations where you don't need them. We have covered the theory, now let's build an actual IK setup using constraints. Select the bone you want to constrain, open new menu, and select the IK constraint. You will enter a mode where spine will ask you to pick a location for target bone. With target bone, you can control that IK. Click on any empty space that would create a new bone. Now give it a name and it would be the target bone for the IK setup. Spine will also create a constraint with the same name, which you can find under constraints node in the tree. You can also create the target bone beforehand and choose it as a target when creating IK constraint. The target bone may look different, but it is simply a bone. The only difference is this annotation icon here. Click on it to open the settings of its IK constraint. In the case of the two bone setup, one of the bones needs to be the direct child of the other. Everything else is similar to one bone IK setup. Select the bones in the menu and pick IK constraint. We are again in the mode where we need to choose or create the target bone. To create it at the tip, we can just click on the child bone and spine will do that for us. Important note that the target bone can never be a child of the constrained bones. If we try to do that, IK constraint will break and be removed from the list in the tree. Okay, now let's use it. To use IK setup in animations, you can control the target bone directly or just put it in the other bone to achieve complex constructions. This way you can achieve muscle stretching and contraction, or other mechanism which I will show you at the end of the video. You may notice that the one bone IK setup is now stretching and contracting. By default, both of these options are turned off. You can find them in the IK Constraint settings. For logical reasons, contraction is not available for two bone IK setup. We can only stretch them. We also have uniform in this row, which will only be active if we enable any of these two options. It basically links the X and Y scale values of the constrained bones. By default, it is disabled. And if we contract this setup, the bone will scale by one of its axes. Let's enable uniform and see that now it scales in both axes. Honestly, I never used it, so can't share any application of it. Maybe you can tell me in the comments. In the same settings, we can change the mix value, which basically tells us how much IK should have an effect on the constrained bones. To turn it off at all, just set it to 0. The good thing is that mix value can be animated, so we can smoothly turn it off and on in the animation. Or maybe we want the bones to be constrained to the multiple IK constraints with the different mix values. Why not? Next, we have a magical slider here, called softness, that comes very handy in some setups. So in general, we have an issue with the IK setups. At the end of its stretched state, it snaps quickly, which produces undesired effect when animated. To avoid that, we can increase the softness and get rid of that snap at all. However, it comes with the cost. Sometimes you may need very quick response from IK constraint. For example, when contacting with the ground. With softness enabled, it will look like it walks on the snow, slowing down the feet while planting them on the ground. I never use softness for the legs. Instead, I try to not use 100% stretched leg states to avoid snapping. I don't know, maybe you can share a leg setup that works with the softness. In general, how you deal with the knee snapping? Let us know in the comments. Another property that we can find in the settings for two bone setup is called positive. It is very simple, just switches the direction the constrained bones bend. However, a lot of people forget that this property can be keyed in the animation. Just make sure the chain is stretched before keying it, otherwise you will have an ugly flip. I will leave the rest settings for you to explore. Now let's try some practical implementations of the IK constraints combined with the path and transform constraints. As I said previously in this video, we can place the target into other bones to simulate muscle stretching and contraction, or maybe achieve better deformation for shoulder joint. For that, select the chest bone and create two bones. Select them and create an IK constraint, placing the target at the tip. Now let's move the target to the arm bone and lastly bind the mesh. This gives us an upside movement that can help you better bind the shoulder meshes. We can see that Tracer has similar setup on the butt cheek. Bones are in the waist bone while target in the leg bone. Remember that those setups are not supposed to be animated. They just enhance the rig. Combining IK with transform constraints, we can rig a knee along with the leg IK, allowing us to move the knee while using IK. I will put the video of detailed tutorial on the knee rigging on the screen. Here is an old rig. It is much more complex than it should be. At that time, I just put everything I knew. However, it is a great example of some applications of techniques that I just showed you. We can see elbows and knees along with the IK constraints. We can see a pouch that has a key target attached to the leg. We have a finger controller that opens and closes hand at once. And another one. Did you know that you can use one bone as a target for multiple IK constraints? Let's construct one. I will add two more bones and create an IK constraint, choosing the same bone as a target. It worked. Of course it would. I checked it 10 times before recording. Cool, let's try playing with this setup. Interesting, we could use it on a ball that would squash and stretch, keeping its volume. Nice. Let's push it further. I think we have something, but not there yet. Let's assume we are rigging a snake. Let's create a head. Put this bone inside it. And almost. We can create a transform constraint to also move the target bone with the head. Not much, a little bit. It feels wrong. Something is not working. Fortunately, I know exactly what's wrong. We need to adjust the order of the constraints. It happens a lot when rigs get complex. First, try to reset the order automatically by pressing this button. If it doesn't work, order them manually. Now let me flip the direction of these bones. If you don't know how to use transform constraint, don't worry. Or you know what, better if you worry, because without transform constraints, you can't build flexible rigs. Check Spine user guide for more info on it. I will put the link on the description. Or subscribe to not miss video about it on this channel. Cool, we have a snake. Let's add some eyes. Perfect. Let me grab one old project for you. Do you recognize? Yes, we were just doing similar setup. And here you can see how it works in action. We also have strings, but I will explain it to you in a moment. First, let's check this snake. Along with the IK constraints, I used pad constraints to achieve smooth bending of the spine. Let's build one now. First, we need a set of bones. Then let's create a path. With all that, we need to select those bones and constrain them to the path. I will cover path constraints in details in the next videos. Now let's create an IK set. And bind that pad to those bones. Yes, exactly. Pad behaves mostly like a mesh. We can bind it to the bones. We can also key its deformation in the animations. That's it. We have it. The last thing you will need to do is to bind the actual mesh to those small bones. It's basically the way how this snake's spine mostly built. This is also the way how those strings are built. Going back to the rigging legs. Sometimes, while animating, legs can rotate weirdly, especially when one bone is much bigger than the other. In those cases, I scale the bones briefly, then bring them back to avoid that effect. And what if you have not an ordinary legs? Maybe it's a horse? For those cases, I suggest this kind of setup. we place the foot bone opposite way and add the target of the IK into that bone. I animated a lot of characters using this setup, so it works. Same way we can set up spider legs. Or even a walking stick, by adding the arm IK target into that bone. In this project we have eyebrows rigged with two bone IK constraints, and those constraints are using the same bone as their target. The reason why they don't directly point to the target is that they have maximum softness value. We also have IK constraints for the pupils. So many use of them. Want to learn how to rig eyes with IK constraints? Check the video on the screen. I'm leaving you with the three limitations of the two bone IK constraints. First is that one of the bones must be the child of the other. Otherwise, you can't create an IK constraint. And to create an IK constraint, bones need to have inheritance of the rotation and scale be enabled. And the last one, if you set the softness value greater than 0, the stretching will not work anymore. Now here's an assignment for you. Go grab a coffee or something, then come back and rig those two legs. Try to animate a simple walk and see if the rig works for you. Then post your results in the Discord channel to collect the feedback. Find the link to the Discord channel in the description. Thank you everyone for watching, and special thanks for these awesome people. See you in the next video. Bye.